So it is difficult when four people are telling the story because it's actually four different stories. I mean, you must realize it's got to be somewhat of a compromise when four people are involved. But we're trying to just say how it felt to us. I mean, it is both a record, a video, a television program, a book, and no doubt somewhere down the line it will also be a t-shirt. Yeah, it was fun. It was good because enough time had gone between 1969 and now. The kind of the Beatles had gone away and we'd all had enough time to breathe, and I think it was much easier to look at it now from a distance. The main gist of it is with the music to find the most ancient Beatle music possible and come in chronological order through the various other records we'd made and bring it up to date, up to now. And then it goes up, I think, into our Hamburg material that we recorded a couple of songs for Polydor. And then goes through some Decca audition. And we've tried to create a lot of the most famous songs, but totally different versions of them. You know, they're just going to probably be, reveling in it. Well, it's always the end of the beginning, isn't it? Play the game existence till the end of the beginning. Yeah, well, we certainly made some good records. Back to the very earliest thing we ever did, which was That'll Be the Day. Made on a home recording of Paul's. Very rough. Oh, it just keeps on coming. There's a lot of very early years, but stuff that hasn't been heard. Television or radio shows from Sweden and various things from the Command Performance, things that just had a one showing on television, but we managed to find the soundtracks to some variety shows we did on television in those early days. And the first record comes right up to, I think it's somewhere around the time of Please Please Me. There's also a very first version of Love Me Do that George Martin found. I mean, it's got to sound like them if it is them, and I'm sure he would have really enjoyed that opportunity to be with us again. It's just some little magic that, when you get certain people together, it produces, it makes fire. The music was always there in the background, reflecting our feelings and our desires and all the various things we'd experienced. And I think it does, it goes in leaps and bounds, and it's pretty interesting. We found different outtakes, or maybe a version of something that had maybe some vocals that were different to the vocals that ended up on the master. So what we've done is present the ultimate version. This became the perfect vehicle because we always had a thing between the three of us, or the four of us at that time, that if any one of us wasn't in it, we weren't going to get, Roger Waters and go out as the Beatles, or Dave Gilmour. We were going to, so therefore, the only other person who could be in it was John.